Hello students, welcome to the gatelectures.com. We are going to start a video series on web technology. Web technology plays a very important role in various examinations like DSSSB, UGC net. And in today's session, we are going to start HTML. HTML is a very important topic in web technology. So let's start, okay? So let's start with HTML introduction. HTML was first developed by Tim Berners Lee in 1991. Initially, HTML proposed in order to design scientific documents to make communication easy between the scientists. And later on, it is adopted by various electronic documents like PDF. And nowadays, it will be used in the World Wide Web in order to describe any web page. So you can see every web page written in the HTML code with different versions. We will discuss about the versions later. So HTML stands for hypertext markup language. So what does it mean by hypertext? Hypertext refer to the way in which web pages, HTML documents, you can say, are linked together. So the entire World Wide Web connected with each other. It means that you can go from one page to another with the help of links, and basically the link present in between the text only. So you can easily jump from one page to another. And the next one is markup language. So what does it mean? It means that it's tell a web browser how to structure it to display. Okay, so we have different versions of HTML. This is HTML 2.0. We were used in 1995. And after 2.0, HTML 4.01 version come. And nowadays, currently we are using the HTML version 5. So let's discuss basic HTML document tags. Okay, so the first one is document type HTML. Okay, so basically this tag defines the document type and the HTML version you are using in your HTML code. Now the next one is HTML. This is the root element. Okay, and this tag basically in this tag you enclose the complete HTML document. Now the next one is head tag. So this tag represents the document header in which you can keep other tags like title and all. Okay, and the next one is title. So this is the title. And in this title, you just mention the document title you want to set, okay? And next one is body tag. So let's close the tag also, title tag. And now after putting the title of the document, now end this tag also. And after start the body tag. So in the body tag, whatever writing in your body will display on your screen. Okay, so let's say you write hello. So at the runtime, hello will print on your screen, and then close this tag, and then close this HTML tag, and that's it. So to learn HTML, basically you will need to study the various text and understand how they behave. While formatting textual document, you easily, more and more text you are used in your HTML document, and it will make your web page very beautiful. So the next is HTML tags and elements. Okay, so let's start with the basic tags. We will discuss each and every tags one by one. And after the completion of the basic tag, I will show you how they will execute on the screen. Okay, so the first one is heading tag. Any document start with a heading. You can use different sizes for your headings like h1, h2, h3, h4, h5 and h6. Okay, so the size of the heading h1 is very large as compared to h2, then h2 size is large as compared to h3, and so on. We give highest priority, or you can say most important heading is h1, and h6 defines the least important heading. Why we are saying that h6 is the least important heading? Because the size is the font size is very small, and the font size of h1 is big. So we can say that we give the highest priority to this as compared to this. Okay. Now the next tag is paragraph tag. So this is the representation of this paragraph tag. It offers a way to structure your text into different paragraphs. Each paragraph of text should go in between an opening P, this tag, and the closing P. Okay, so this is the tag for the paragraph tag. Okay, so whatever you write in between this paragraphs, so after the completion of your text, just close this paragraph tag. The next one is line break tag. The line break tag basically used to define the break between the starting a new paragraph. Okay, if you write anything, say hello, okay, and you want to break this this line or this paragraph, so just put break and the next text you're writing, like hello, how are you, will print on next line. Okay, and important point is it is an empty tag. What does it mean? In the empty tag, you don't need to when opening tag or closing tag. Empty tag is there is no end tag. We just write the name of the tag and the put slash after that. Okay, so this is an empty tag. Next tag is center tag. So this is the representation of this tag. And this tag used to put any content in the center of the page. So if you put this tag in your text, so whatever you write in your body comes in the center of the page or screen. The next one is horizontal tag. So this is also a empty tag. We don't need any closing tag and all. And this is an empty tag and tag. You can say empty element. And this horizontal tag are used to visually break up sections of a document. It provides a line between the two paragraphs. I will show you. So this is the HTML call for all the basic HTML tags we already discussed. So let's execute all the tags one by one. Okay. So the first tag we already discussed is heading tag. And so I'm using the H1 and H6 heading tag. H1 the most important heading tag because the font size is very large as compared to the other tags, and H6 tag is the font size is very small as compared to other tags. Okay, so let's try to execute this text with the help of this tags H1, and this is the starting tag and this is the close tag. Okay, so try to run, and you can use any browsers. I'm using the Chrome browser. Okay, so let's try to execute this code. So you can see that the text I already did on my most important heading. So I'm using in this text I'm using the header size H1, and this is the most this is the most important heading size because the size of the text is very large. Can easily see that, and I'm in this on my least important heading. I'm using the H6 heading, so this is a very small as compared to the H1. Okay, so this is how they looks like in the screen. Okay, so the next tag is paragraph text. In the paragraph text, this is that our tag we are using for the paragraph text. I'm writing the two lines. And this line is enclosed between these opening and close tag of paragraph tag, and this is the second line. And I'm going to I'm going to use two paragraph text, one for this line and one for this line. Let's see how they look like on the screen. Okay, let's try to execute this program. So I'm going to run and launch in Chrome. Okay. So due to the first heading 1 or a heading 6, these texts are visible, and the second one is paragraph text. Okay, so this is the first line of paragraph, and I'm using the paragraph text. That's why the next line is shown at the below of the first line in a very paragraph manner. Okay, so the next one are the horizontal text and the center text. we already discussed the working of these tags. So let's discuss. I'm going to show you how they will looks like on a screen. Okay, so launching Chrome and okay, so just because of horizontal tag, these line is shown. It's a horizontal line, and this horizontal line divides the two into two parts. First part is this, and the second part is after the horizontal tag. And just because of the center tag, this text is aligned at the center. Okay. So next is formatting elements. In word processor, you all are familiar with the bold, italic, underline types of tags. Some of them we are using in the HTML also. So the formatting elements were designed to display special types of text like this bold tag, same as the word processor. Now next one is strong tag. Its working is basically same as the bold text only. Okay, I will show you. And the next one is this italic tag is same as the word processor tag. And the next one is emphasized tag. This working is almost is all same like the italic text only, and this is important tag also. And the next one is this is underline tag, used same as the word processor for the underline the text. And the next one is mark tag, mark the particular particular word or particular tag, or you can say highlighted the particular text. Okay, next one is small tag, with the small text. Next tag is inserted text, then deleted text, want to delete anything. And the next is monospace tag. So what is this monospace tag? In most of the fonts, you can say a very variable length, or very wider in length, just like we have different letters like O and I. This letter is wider than this letter. Okay, so we want each letter should be with same width. So in for that purpose, we are using the monospaced tag, and this is the functionality of this tag. And the next is a subscript tag to write below. And the next is superscript, like 2 raised to power 2. So this is a superscript functionality of this tag. Okay, so let's try to execute all those formatting elements one by one. Okay, so these are all the formatting elements. Let's execute all the formatting elements one by one. So I've write this. This is text is normal, so I'm not using any formatting elements in this paragraph. So this is a normal paragraph. And next one is bold. I'm using the formatting element bold tag, and this text is bold. Now I'm using this tag break because I want to write next line in another line. Okay, this text is italic, and I'm using this italic tag, and this is the emphasized tag. Working is same. Okay, so let's try to execute. I'm going on to run, launching Chrome. Let's see. Okay, so this text is normal. The text which I write on in between the paragraph tag. Now this text is bold. Okay, I'm using the bold tag. Now after that, I'm using the italic tag. So this tag is italic form, and this tag is emphasized. I've already discuss with you that these italic and emphasized tag working are almost same. So you can see that this tag is italic and this tag is emphasized is written in a same manner. Okay, so the next tags are mark and small. So mark is used to highlight the particular text or any word, and small is used for the small text. Okay, so let's try to run these tags and let's see. Okay. Okay, so mark this whole text. So just because of mark tag, the whole line which I have written in between the mark tag is marked, and the next, due to the small tag, this tag is small, is written in very small font. Okay, so the next tags are insert, delete tags. So let's try to uncomment these two tags. Okay, and then we will execute it. So we have already discussed the functionality of this insert and delete tag. Now let's try to execute them. Okay, so insert text is used to, you know, to insert any text. So the underline is come in between this text you want to insert. And the next one is my favorite color is white, not black. Okay, so the black part is deleted, and you are able to see the deleted part also. Okay, so the next one is monospaced tag. So let's try to uncomment this tag. Okay, so this is, I'm going to save it and run it. Okay, so basically monospace used so that our each letter should have same width. So use monospace tag for same width. You can see I'm using the monospace tag in monospace tag, and in this monospace tag I have written this monospace text. So the monospace this text is same, all the letters are of same width. Okay, so next are subscript and superscript. So we will uncomment this two tags also, save it and try to run it. You can see that. Okay, just because of subscript, these two will go down. Okay, so you can easily find out the how to write the log based with the log 8 with base 2, and with the help of subscript tag you can easily write all the powers of any number. Okay, so the power of 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. So